Hello everyone. Today my topic for discussion is another new chapter from community medicine, which is environment. So first of all, I will talk about how to remove the hardness of water. So before we talk about removal of hardness of water, first of all, we should know why there is hardness of water. This is actually soap destroying power of the water, and this happened due to calcium and magnesium salt. And if we want to know in detail that what is the cause, why the hardness of the water is there, this is due to presence of calcium, mainly the bicarbonate, sulfate, nitrate and chloride. When all these elements are present in the water, so they can lead to hardness of the water. So now we will talk about how to remove the hardness of water. So there are two ways we can remove the hardness of water. One is temporary method by simple boiling. So if we boil the water, so what will happen? The calcium bicarbonate will convert it into CaCO3. So this CaCO3, this doesn't cause the hardness of water. And the second method is addition of lime. What is lime? This is calcium hydroxide. So when calcium bicarbonate plus we add calcium hydroxide, it is again converted into. The next method is purification of the water. So if we store the water for 5 to 7 days, so what will happen that all the impurities will settle down within 24 hours and it will clear about 90% impurities. As well as all the bacteria in the water due to oxygen will oxidize and bacterial count 90% will also reduce. Another method for the purification of the water is chlorination. Now this is important for exam point of view. When water become yellow, so if we add chlorine in this water, so what will happen? Chlorine plus water, it will form hypochlorous acid plus ACl. Now this hypochlorous acid, it is the main disinfectant. This is the MCQ that if we add chlorine in the water, so which main disinfectant will form? So this is this main disinfectant, which is hypochlorous acid, and it is main disinfectant. And now this chlorination has many benefits. First of all, it is germicide. All the pathogenic bacteria will kill, as well as algae in the water and other organic matter will also dissolve or destroy. Another method is if we store the water for 5 to 7 days. If we store the water for 5 to 7 days and to want to get the purification in short time, so what we will add? We will add alum. So if we will add alum, we will get the purification of the water in short time. So what is this alum? This is actually chemical coagulant aluminium sulfate. So what will happen that when we add the alum, it will bind with all the impurities and then do sedimentation. So what is the dose for it? The dose is about 35 milligram per liter. This is the dose. When we add the alum, so we will get in short duration purification of the water. So now I will talk about the water filtration. So there are two methods for water filtration. First is rapid sand filter and second is slow sand filter. This rapid sand filter, it was formed in 1885 in America, and slow sand filter. And this slow sand filter, it is developed in 1804 in Scotland. So now we will learn how to filter by rapid and slow method. So this is slow method and this is rapid. First of all, in both cases, we will take supernatant water. The water which is stored for 3 to 5 days. Then in the slow method, the sand will be at the base of reservoir. There will be sand. And then it will undergo sedimentation for 3 to 5 days and then a vital layer is formed. Now what is this vital layer? This vital layer is actually the collection of algae, plankton, diatom, all the unicellular organism. About after 3 to 5 days, this vital layer will form. And then the drainage system and filter control valve will be open, so water is filtered. So again, what is slow sand filtration? First of all, there is supernatant water which is stored for 3 to 5 days. Then there will be sand at the base of reservoir, and then it will undergo sedimentation for 5 to 7 days, and a vital layer is formed. This vital layer is actually the collection of algae, plankton and unicellular organism. Then water under drainage system and open the valve, so get filtered water. Now, what is rapid sand filtration? In the rapid sand filtration, again there is supernatant water, but instead of sand there will be coagulation of water, mean we will add the alum to get rapid sand filtration. Now this alum, about 35 milligram per liter, the dose is about 35 milligram per liter, and then there will be rapid mixing, and then flocculation means slow and gentle mixing, and then it will undergo sedimentation. About 2 to 6 hours it will undergo sedimentation, so all the impurities will bind with the alum. So then under drainage system we will control this by valve, so the water is filtered. This is rapid sand filtration. So this is all about today's class. Like